Good morning, children. Welcome back to our English class. Today, we are going to continue our lesson, The Trial, ADD. Already in the previous class, we know and we have already known the characters whose are played in this play. Okay, children? Now, once again, I recall you what is the story, the play, or the story, the theme of this lesson, The Trial. So, Joan of Arc, a peasant, French peasant girl who claimed and who fought against the British army. She is a French girl and she fought for her mother earth, motherland, and for the sake of France. She fought against the English army. After the siege of Orleans, 9 days, and taking back the city of Reims, there the trial is going on. Okay, children, we have already known the characters' names. Here the table has given for you, and if you open your textbooks, page number 129. Okay, children, I want to say you may follow me while I am reading, because this lesson, the names, those given in our text are not familiar to us, because these names are from French names. While I am reading, you go through the book and be careful on my pronunciation, at my pronunciation. Okay, children? Have you opened? Okay. Yes. Now I am reading Rouen, 30 May 1431, a great stone hall in the castle, arranged for a trial at law. There are two raised chairs side by side for the bishop and the inquisitor as judges. Looking down the great hall from the middle of the inner end, the judicial chairs and the scribes' table are to the right. The prisoner's stool is to the left. There are arched doors right and left. It is a fine sunshiny May morning. Okay, children. After she was captured by the English army, she has been brought to the Rouen, the place, on 30 May 1431. There was a trial going on. So, a great stone hall. Here, the place where she had been brought, here means the place, a great stone hall in the castle, arranged for a trial at law. So, here there is the description of the hall. Here, they have given the description of the hall. Okay, children, who are sitting on the chairs in that hall means bishop. Do you know, children, who is bishop? So, bishop, pope, father, these are the people, priests, the clergyman or priest, who is praising the Lord, who is working for the sake of God in the churches. These are the designations of the church. the religious heads, the religious priests. Okay, bishop means a clergyman who supervises a number of local churches. So he supervises the local small churches if any small churches are there in the town, in that area. So he supervises. So that designation is called bishop. Here the bishop and the inquisitor. Inquisitor means an official with judicial. So when we investigate anything, so what is right and what is wrong, is the crime happened, is it proved or not, so these are the investigation who does is called inquisitor. Is also one kind of a judge here. Bishop and the inquisitor both are sat on the chairs in that great stone hall room. Looking down the great hall from the middle of the inner end, the judicial chairs and scribes table are to the right. Scribe. Children, while I am reading the text, you have to watch line by line. Then you take one pencil, you underline the strange words which you don't know. Okay children, afterwards I will give you glossary. Then you take the meanings and you note down in your notebooks. Scribe means someone employed to make written copies or documents. The writer, when we go to the police station, the writer, one employee is employed, one person is employed to write a case. What is the case? How did it happen? Where did it happen? So these all the things he had to write. The person has called a name scribe, especially legal documents here. The prisoner's stool is to the left. There are archway doors right and left. It is a fine, sunshiny May morning. So it took place in May, sunshiny morning. The inquisitor. Now the play is running, the characters came and they delivered their dialogues. In our schools, we want to give the names to some children. You are inquisitor and you are Jonah, or you act like this and you act like Lord Venu. So these characters will give. But now there is no opportunity to have in a classroom situation, so that we go through as given in our textbook. Okay children. The inquisitor. Let the accused be brought in. Lord Venu. Calling the accused, let her be brought in. John, chained by the ankles, is brought in through the arched door behind the prisoner's stool by a guard of English soldiers. With them is the executioner and his assistants. They lead her to the prisoner's stool and place themselves behind it after taking off her chain. She wears a page black suit. Children, have you ever seen a court? Haven't you? Yes, we saw in movies or in TV serials, etc. But we don't have to see the court directly. If anybody have watched, okay. So, who are there in that court? Judges placed in the high position of that dais. Before the judge, one row of the lawyers, prosecutors, lawyers, scribes, witnesses, and servants. These are placed. So, this is a what is called picture of a court. So when we imagine that court, so we imagine the rows who are the before the judge. So this picture we can imagine. Okay children, now she came. So she is she was accused, so she has been brought by child. So they had hand pills and child handcuffs. So this she has been brought like that. She wears a page black suit. Page means a knight who is fought against the government and is a knight, soldier or knight. So they have been dressed a black suit, in a black suit that is called page in France. So she came in that dress. Now the invisor kindly see John. She sits on the prisoner's stool. You look very pale today. Are you not well? So the invisor asked the wellness how she was. He asked some questions about her health and about her health condition. So why are you looking pale, John? He asked. Now John is answering to the invisor. Thank you, I'm well enough. But the bishop sent me some car and it made me ill. You know, children, what is carp? Carp is one kind of a fish. They use it to take food and they mostly depend on the seafood. So they had to be fed by a carp by the judicial or that department in prison. Kushan, I'm sorry, I told them to say that it was fresh. So here, fish is not in danger, but here she has fed a stale food, which is unfresh. Okay, so that's why when we take some stale food yesterday or before the day in the refrigerator, we may have some ill health, cough or something cold, so we feel like that. So here also, she took the stale food, that's why she was very pale and ill health, to seem to be sick. John, you mean to be good to me? I know, but it is a fish that does not agree with me. The English thought you were trying to poison me. So you have given me fish, but it is a stain so that it may cause me to sick. So one kind of poison. You are that they think you try to poison me. Cushion and the chaplain together. What? No, my lord. They are the caretakers of John and they had to present before the court. So until they had to look her in the what we call her care about her health. Okay, so they don't have to feed her stale food, but they gave. John, continue. They are determined that I shall be burned as a witch. And they sent their doctor to cure me. But he was forbidding to blame me because the silly people believe that a witch's witchery leaves her if she is bled. So he only called me filthy names. Why do you leave me in the hands of the English? I shall be in the hands of the church. And why must I be chained by the feet to a log of wood? Are you afraid? I will fly away. Here, John wanted to say that they are determined that I shall be burned as a witch. So here, who are they? The judicial department, the English army. So they thought that they came to determine. Determination means the focus, you need to get something done. Whether it is right or wrong, so we have to do that. So came into a decision, strong decision. So they are determined that I shall be burnt as a witch. Do you know, children, who is witch? those who done black magic. Means in Sahasaveera Sagara Kanya, in that movie. And we have so many movies, we have seen that kind of ladies go in Arundhati. So, some characters. So, the characters are especially lady who does to think thought to have magic powers, mostly evil ones. To cause evil to the others with the use of magic powers. She is called a witch. So what we do? Chetabadi, Banamati, like this. So what the villagers or some others do with that kind of ladies? They burnt lively. So not to do any other person like that in their village. Here also, the English army thought that she was a witch. So they wanted to burn life. And they sent their doctor to cure me. But he was forbidden to bleed me because the silly people believe that a witch's witchery leaves her if she is bleed. So when bleed means when a knife or something cut to our body, then blood coming up to up from our body, that is called bleeding. So maybe death occurs to her. No. The doctors came to the court and cured her. Because when a punishment gives to the prisoner or accused, the court must notice his health condition. When he is perfectly right, then only they give the punishment to the accused. So that's why the doctors came to check her health and cured her. Okay, children. And why must I be joined by the feet of a log of wood? So she was taken to the court by her ankles, her hands with the chains. And she was tied to the feet of a log of wood. I have shown you in the picture, in the page number 133. See the picture how she was tied to the log of wood. So, because in their opinion, she was accused and she was criminal. Okay, children, are you afraid I will fly away? So, she wanted to not to do in the hands of English army. Whatever the punishment, if she does anything wrong, if she did anything wrong to the country or motherland or in the opinion of judicial, but the punishment was given, right to give it to the only to the church, but not the English army. So she did not want to in the hands of English. She did not want to the punishment taken by the English. Wanted to taken by the punishment taken by only the church. Okay, children. Now, they estimate harshly. Women, it's not for you to question the court. It is for us to question you. So you don't have to write to deliver a word, to talk a word in this court. If anyone, anything you want to say, you question us, but not the court. Courtless, when you were left unchained, did you not try to escape by jumping from a tower 60 feet high? If you cannot fly like a witch, how is it that you are still alive? So, who is courtless here? Children, the Canon of Paris is a young priest who helps to compile 64 charges against Joan. So, they are forcing, they are compelling the Joan, you have done these types of crimes because of broken laws. When here in the opinion of church or in the opinion of English army, it is that Joan was broken the laws of France. France means in English only. Now, because France was captured by the English army, now, so that why she has broken. She had broken the law, so that why she has to be been brought to the court for her trial. Okay, children. Joan. I suppose because the tower was not so high then. It has grown higher every day since you began asking me questions about it. So, what did Cortilis ask? When you were left unchained, in case of we remove your chains by sympathy or some a lady. So, that's why we show a sympathy, a mercy to you, and we unchained you, what will you do? Then, you jump a tower 60 feet high because you are a witch. You know the black magic. So that's why you can jump the tower which is 60 feet high. If you cannot fly like a witch, how is it that you are still learning? If you cannot fly like a witch, how is it that you are still alive? So how can you still alive? Now Joan answered that I suppose because the tower was not so high then. So if I am a witch, it is not the matter of 60 or 100 or 1000. It is the matter of the height of the tower. So I have the black magic powers. I have the black magic powers. Whatever you understood about me. So whatever you think about me. So I can fly not only the 60, more than that. Okay, children. It has grown higher every day since you began asking me questions about it. So you have been brought to the trials there. Trial means only 1 or 2 days doesn't come to the decision. It has to be proved a crime or something, theft or something else. So it has to be proved, and it is the court is adjourned by her proofs also, and they wanted to give the time to the accused to submit the what it proves. So that how many times I came for the trials, and every day the feet of the tower is increases. Why did you say me? Tell me. So in this way she answered to the courtiers. Dear Esteem, why did you jump from the tower? So Esteem asked, why did you jump from the tower? Joan, how do you know that I jumped? How do you know I jumped? You told and I was jumped. So how do you know that I jumped from the tower? The Esteem, you were found lying in the moat. Why did you leave the tower? So children, have you ever seen a fort? Warangal Fort and Golconda Fort, Jhansi Lakshmi Bai Fort. Whenever the kings ruled their kingdom, they built surrounding, they dig one kind of mound. So mound means a deep, wide ditch surrounding castle fort filled with water. In that water, they made the crocodiles, snakes, like these kind of dangerous animals. They live in that water because if any rivals or some enemies wanted to capture, wanted to enter the fort of the king, the king's fort or the king's kingdom. So they hadn't to enter, not to enter. So they did the surrounding, the total surrounding of the fort. They did one wide moat, and it is filled with water. So they couldn't jump. They couldn't jump, or they couldn't enter the fort. That is called moat. So how do you know? Why you were found lying in the moat? Why did you leave the tower? John, why would anybody leave a prison if they could get out? Why would anybody leave a prison if they could get out? DST, you tried to escape. If anybody, the thief or the accused, one person, will lock up or be put into prison, then what type of the mental condition of that prisoner, of that person who is in the prison, in that cell? So whatever the chance, a little chance is he wanted to get out from the prison. Arichinana, are you following me? Yes, one prisoner. Yet whatever the person who is in the prison, so their mental condition is like that. So we want to, the person who is inside the cell, inside the prison, in the prison, they wanted to get out from the prison. Okay, Nana. In this way, Joan also liked it. She wanted to get out from the prison. Joan, of course I did. And not for the first time either. Yes, I tried to get out from the prison. So this is not the first time. I had already tried. But you don't like it. If you leave the door of the cage open, the bird will fly out. So, when a we love animals, birds, etc., etc. Okay, children, you love them? Yes, we all love the animals and birds, sweet birds like parrot. So we love so much that parrot. So we can buy from the market. When we take the parrot and we keep in the cage, which is in a gold frame. Or silver frame or costly frame cage. So we build a gray cage. We keep the parrot in that cage. Does the parrot happy? Because it is gold, it is diamonds, and it is platinum cage. Is it happy? No, children. When a bird or a man is free from the boundaries, then only we feel free. When we have freedom, then only we are the luckiest persons in the world. So that the parrot also thinks. So when we keep it, when we put it in a cage, always what the parrot thinks every day when we see the parrot every day in the morning. So when do I get out from this cage? How do I escape? So like that. The parrot thinks in the same way. She was in prison. So that parrot, she wanted to get out from the prison. So she tried. If there is any chance of her, she try. She get out from that prison. Okay, children. Okay. Now they esteem. Rising means here. Stand. Rise means stand here. Rise means when I rise in the morning, wake up, rise, the sun rises, I rise at 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock. So that is one kind of rise. And here rise means stand up, stood. That is a confession of heresy. I call the attention of the court to it. Heresy. What is heresy? You have given the meaning and the glossary. Here, heresy means a belief which is against the principles of Christianity. So in those days, I already told you in my previous class, children, in those days the total powers, ruling powers, are in the hands of religious heads. She has done some acts in this text. That is, she has broken the laws of Christianity. So that is called heresy. Mata paramainatuvanti nere heresy. John. What is heresy? John. Heresy. He calls it. Am I a heretic? Because I try to escape from prison. Heresy. Heresy. Am I a heretic? What do you think? Am I a heretic? Because I try to escape from prison. So when I try to escape from this prison, that is a heresy. That is, I am a heretic. Am I a heretic? She asked, be escape. Okay, children. Now, have you underlined the words? You don't know the meanings, and they are strange to you. They are not familiar to you. I'll give you glossary, and you note down the glossary, the meanings you take down. Okay, children. Now, I'll ask some questions, comprehension questions. Now, have you listened to the text? Now, from these comprehensions, from these passages, I want to ask questions. How much you understand? Okay, children. Can you give me answers? Okay. Okay. Yes. What was the name of the heroine of this lesson, and which country she belonged? Okay, I know you must. You are all will know the name of the heroine. Okay, yes. The name of the heroine in this lesson is Jonafor. She belonged to France. The next question: who was accused in the opinion of inquisition? Who is the accused here? Who is coming taking to the court for the trial? Yes, yes, Jonafor. Correct, you are correct now. Jonafor was the accused in the opinion of inquisition. Then, the third one. Where did the trial in law took place? Where did the trial in law took place? The trial in law took place in a great stone hall in Rouen city in France. Okay. What made her see God in hell? So the God, please, that person, the invisible question asked. So today you are looking so pale, John. Why? He asked. So pale means when we get fever. So we didn't take any sufficient food, then our face will become pale. Okay, children. So now here, Jonafor's face is also pale. So the inquisitor asked, what made you sick? Some pot sent by the bishop made her sick. Okay, children. The pot means is a stale food, the fish also, but it is not a fresh food, stale food. Stale food, if we take stale food, what will happen? It may cause poison to our health. Okay, children. Now, in whose hands she wanted to be? She didn't want to be in the hands of English army. She wanted to be in the hands of the church. What was the punishment they wanted to give? She happily allowed, denied. But here she didn't want to to be in the hands of English because they captured the motherland. So she was fighting for her motherland, to save her motherland from the Britishers. Okay, children, do you agree Joan of Arc was a heretic? What is your opinion? No. Do you agree Joan of Arc was a heretic? No, not at all. Not at all. Yes. I don't agree with the opinion of Eurytions. In my opinion, she was a patriotic knight. Knight means who fight for the sake of her motherland, for the motherland's freedom. Freedom is heaven. Okay, children? Freedom is heaven, whereas slavery is hell. Yes. For the sake of her motherland against the Britishers. So, okay, children, you have well answered to my questions. Now the time is assignment. I'll give you one assignment, children. You take down and you do the assignment and send it to your subject teachers, accused. Thank you, children. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.